Hello everyone, welcome to Skillsville Training YouTube channel. Myself Mohammad Zubair, and this channel is all about showing you how to become an IT pro really fast. So the topic of today's video is Windows 11 system requirements explained. So without any further ado, let's get started. Microsoft announced the Windows 11, and they also have confirmed that Windows 11 can be upgraded from the Windows 10. Means if you are using Windows 10, you can upgrade to Windows 11 without downloading Windows 11 itself. Microsoft also confirmed that the new operating system will have different hardware requirements. This means that not all the systems will be compatible with the new operating system. And only those systems will be able to upgrade to Windows 11 which adhere to the minimum hardware requirements. This is because Microsoft has announced new minimum requirements to install or to have Windows 11 in your system. And obviously, not all the systems which are already running Windows 10 have those minimum requirements. I will get to minimum requirements later. First of all, I want to talk about a tool here, PC Health Check. I will open it. So I will search for PC Health Check. Here it is. I will just open it. It is an official application from the Microsoft, and it lets you to check if your system is able or it is compatible with the minimum requirements, and whether if it can run the Windows 11 on your hardware or not. You can download it from the official website of Microsoft. I will leave the link below as well. Here you can see we have a button which says check now. If I click on it, it will check if my system is compatible with the minimum requirements for Windows 11. So I will click on it, and here it says this PC can't run Windows 11. And down here it says the processor isn't supported for Windows 11. The processor which I have in my hardware isn't supported for Windows 11, and it doesn't adhere to the minimum requirements for Windows 11. So I will close this one. If you scroll down, you have other information here as well about Windows update, battery capacity, storage capacity, and startup time, etc. So I will close this one. And now let's talk about the minimum requirements itself. This is the official page from Microsoft, and here we have the minimum requirements. In terms of processor, Windows 11 needs 1 GHz or faster with 2 or more core processor, but it should be compatible with 64-bit processor. In terms of memory, we need 4 GB of RAM, and in terms of storage, we need 64 GB minimum. In terms of system firmware, we need UEFI and secure boot capable. In terms of graphic card, we must have DirectX 12. In terms of display, Windows 11 needs 720 pixel of display. I have not talked about the TPM here. I will talk about it later, and I will talk about it in detail. First of all, let's talk about the processor. This is the official document of Microsoft, and here we have all the information related to processor which are needed and which are required for Windows 11. Here we have all the information for Windows Client Edition processor. Here you have the list of Windows Edition, like you can see here, Windows 7, Windows 10, then we have different version of Windows 10, and down here we have Windows 11. Apart from that, we also have the processor information against each Windows edition. Like against Windows 7, we have AMD processor list, and then we have Intel processor list. So for example, if you want to check that which processor is compatible with Windows 7 in terms of AMD, just click on this link and you will have the list of all the processors which are compatible. We are concerned with Windows 11 here, so I will scroll down. So before moving further, I want to talk to you about some more things here. Here you have all the information about Windows IoT core processor, and down here you will have enterprise and then servers. So if you are interested in this information, go through this page and you will have a lot of information. I will leave the link in the description as well. Now let's scroll up again, and here is Windows 11, and this is the list for AMD processor, and this is the list for Intel processors. I'm going to find out that which processors of Intel are supported for Windows 11. I will click on it, and here we have whole list of processors which are compatible with Windows 11 in terms of Intel. Question comes into mind that how to check if my processor or the processor in my system is compatible for Windows 11 or not, there is a simple solution, and that is right click on your start button and go to system. Here it is, just click on it, and here you can see here it says 5300U. This is the processor number, or you can say processor model, for your system. Just copy it. I will close this one and come to this page and try to match your copied number from the available list here. So I will press Ctrl F. It will open a finder for me. Here I will paste the number, and here you can see it says 0x0. It means we do not have a processor with the name or with this model here. My processor is not compatible for Windows 11, and I cannot install or upgrade to Windows 11 with this hardware. So I will close this one now, and here is the list. So what you can do, you can copy your processor model or processor name, and you can just match it here, and you will have an idea that whether your processor is compatible or not. And now let's check the supported AMD processor for Windows 11. This is the list for the all AMD processors, and if your system or your hardware have AMD processor in it, just copy your processor name or processor model and just try to match it here. If you find it, it means your hardware is compatible to install Windows 11 or to upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11. So this was all about the processors which are required for your hardware to install Windows 11 or to upgrade to Windows 11 from Windows 10. Now let's get back to the requirements. Now we have talked about the processor, memory and storage. Now let's talk about the TPM. Well, TPM is a word which is buzzing around a lot in recent time. Well, the reason is this is the most difficult, or you can say most rare requirement which most of the system have at the moment, because most of the system, or you can say most of the hardware which were manufactured before 2014, do not have this TPM version 2.0. They have TPM version 1.2, and that is why a lot of people are talking about it, because if you do not have TPM version 2.0, you cannot install or you cannot upgrade to Windows 11 from Windows 10. Let's see what is TPM, what it do, and why it was manufactured. Well, TPM stands for Trusted Platform Module, and it is a microchip which is often built to a computer to provide hardware-based security, and it can be added later by user by attaching the chip to motherboard. So basically, it is a hardware module which is meant for providing you the hardware-based security. If you talk about what does a TPM do, well, some of the data that we transmit throughout the day is sent unencrypted as plain text. So what does TPM do here? It uses a mix of hardware and software to protect your transmitted data. And if it in case, it senses that the integrity of your system has been compromised by a virus or malware, it can start up in a quarantine mode to help you fix the problem. So this is why TPM is very important. Because if you remember, in Microsoft Windows 10 2.1 H1 update, Microsoft put a lot of emphasis on security. So it was obvious that in Windows 11, Microsoft will have more emphasis on security related feature. Now, how to check which version of TPM your system has at the moment? To check that, just press Windows plus R button on your keyboard and just write tpm.msc, as you can see on your screen. And after that, just hit enter. And here you can see we have all the information about TPM, and down here we have specification version, which is 1.2. It means I'm also not able to install Windows 11 into my system. I must have TPM 2.0 to install Windows 11. Most of you might not see this information. This is might be because you do not have enabled it in your system. To enable TPM in your system, you have to restart your system, and then you have to go into boot menu. To go into boot menu, you have to press the boot key. For every system, boot key is different. For example, I am using Dell. For Dell, F2 or F12 is a boot key. In my case, I am using F2. So when you restart your system, keep pressing your boot key and you will get into boot menu. From there, go to security, and from security, go to TPM option and just enable it. And then you will be able to see all the information about TPM here. That was all about the minimum requirements related to Windows 11. And now I will tell you some interesting thing, and that is there are rumors that Microsoft might reconsider their minimum requirements for Windows 11. And to defend my argument, Microsoft PC Health Check app was also taken down by the company after mass feedback on the tool's lack of information as to why a system will not be able to run Windows 11. And this is the tool I'm talking about. Well, it was taken down by the Microsoft because there was mass feedback from the people that it was giving inappropriate information and it was giving incomplete information that why people's system are not able to install Windows 11 or what were the reason behind that. But then Microsoft said, we will get it back online in preparation for general availability this fall. And they said this in a post. So it means that there are firm chances that Microsoft might reconsider or might renegotiate the minimum requirements for Windows 11, because there are millions of devices which are running on TPM version 1.2, and there are billions of devices which are running the processor which are not available in the list which I have just shown you. So we might see minimum requirements again from the Microsoft. And that brings us to the end of today's video, and I hope that you have learned a lot of things today. And if that is the case, please leave a like and subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to press the bell icon. If you have something to ask, please leave a comment below. We will get back to you as soon as possible. Till the next video, take care.